Hi folks. This gentleman over here, his name is Harry Harrison, Ambassador Harry Harrison to South Korea. Prior to this gentleman being an ambassador, 40 years service in the United States Navy, rose up to the rank of Admiral in the Pacific Command. Now, he retires after 40 years and President Trump appoints him as ambassador to South Korea because of his knowledge of the Pacific region and Asia. Well, now a lot of South Koreans are complaining about him. They got criticism towards this gentleman, towards the ambassador. And the reason for the criticism, so they say, but we'll get to the real reason. The reason for the criticism is he has a mustache. How dare you wear a mustache in South Korea? We in South Korea find mustaches offensive. No mustache. You understand? Shave it or get out. Yeah. That mustache is offensive to them, so they say. To which I have to say, really? Well, as we say in Japan, Majikayo! Hotani? That mustache is not offensive to them. It's just an excuse. You know what's offensive to them about the ambassador? Well, there's two things, but the main reason? He was born in Japan from a Japanese mother and an American sailor father. That's what's offensive. He's got Japanese blood in him, you understand? And he's an American ambassador? We don't like him. Let's find an excuse. We're not going to be able to say because he has a Japanese mother. We'll say because it's the mustache. The mustache is offensive in South Korea, so we're going to criticize him because of the mustache. The mustache is offensive? No. If there's him having a Japanese mother, that's what's offensive. Another offense that he's committed to some of the people in South Korea, notably the communist agitators behind this, when he was an admiral of the U.S. command in the Pacific region, he publicly announced on numerous occasions the danger the communists in China posed to the region as well as the world. As a result, the monsters in Beijing kept imploring to President Trump, get rid of him! Get him out of the Pacific area! We don't want him in command of U.S. military forces! Yeah! That's what they kept doing. But Trump ignores them. Thank God. But he, after 40 years, time to retire. So when he retired, being a military man now, or former military man, he's starting a new life. And on his new life, he wanted to present a new persona. Well, he wasn't able to grow at his age, right? Can't do that. Gee, so what else can I do? Maybe I could get younger. No, he couldn't get younger. I'll grow a mustache, change my appearance. And lo and behold, that's the claim. They're not going to say it's because he irritated the commies. They're not going to say it because he has a Japanese mother. It's the mustache, and that's serious business in South Korea. Men with mustaches. Really? Is that what it is? Now, I searched exhaustively on the internet, and it's not the final authority, but I really could not find current Korean men with mustaches. But you know what I did find? A hero in South Korea has a mustache. This mug. He's a national hero throughout the Korean Peninsula and parts of China. And you know why this Korean popular? Why he's a hero? And children are taught to admire him. He's a murderer. More accurately, he's an assassin. He assassinated a former Japanese official. That made him a hero. The children are taught to admire this assassin, this murderer, this man with a mustache. It's okay for the assassin to have the mustache, but it better not be on the American ambassador's face. Yeah, you understand? You know something, folks? I think what I'm going to do the next time I come across one of those comfort woman statues is adore it with a mustache. Yeah, put a mustache on that hunk of junk instead of placing the paper bag protecting its head from bird poop. Or we could just put the mustache on the paper bag. See? Problem solved. So whenever you think of South Korea, think of mustaches. That's what they want you to think of. And if you're a man, you better not have one while you're in South Korea. If you're an ambassador to the United States, if you're anti-communist, or if you have any Japanese blood in you, lugheads. We'll see you. God bless you. God bless America. God bless the nation you happen to be in. And dear God, please, for the safety of Ambassador Harry Harris, because a previous ambassador during the Obama regime, American ambassador, his face was sliced by a South Korean in South Korea. They have no problem with assassinating previous presidents, slicing up Japanese officials, slicing up American ambassadors. They have no problem at all. And then they point to the United States for the violence here. See ya. Ha 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 ha!